Vasudevaya.
Okay, so we're telling about Gop Kumar, the cowherd boy from Govardhan and his travels.
我们一直在讲述的是Gopakumar，他是Govardhan山的一位牧牛童，他的旅行心路历程。
So we heard how he'd gone up to Brahmaloka, and when he was in Brahmaloka, the Supreme Lord told him about going. He should go back to Mathura, and there he would meet his spiritual master and get instruction from his guru.
就在Brahmaloka上面告诉他，你现在应该回到Goloka，你应该回到Mathura，你在那会遇见你的灵性导师，你的guru会给你一些训示。So
when Gop Kumar came back from Brahmaloka, he came back to Earth. He saw that everything had changed, everything except Mathura, except Vrindavan. Vrindavan, Mathura, that had not changed.
他们回到了地球，才发现一切都改变了，就除了Vrindavan、Mathura之外。And
Vrindavan, Govardhan Hill was still there. The Kalindi, or the Yamuna River, was still there. And the same animals were there, the peacocks, the monkeys, the cows, and the Brijbasi people.
戈尔丹山还在那里，卡林迪、亚木纳河还在那里，动物们也都在，孔雀、猴子、母牛，还有布拉扎巴西们全都在那里。So,
Gop Kumar remembered when he'd been in Brahmaloka, the Mahapurush, the Supreme Lord there in Brahmaloka, had told him that in Mathura you'll be able to see your spiritual master.
他回忆起在Brahmaloka上面，至尊主Mahapurusha曾经告诉他，在Mathura他能见到自己的灵性导师。
So he was wondering, Gop Kumar was wondering about Vrindavan. He was wandering through the different forests, and then he came back to the place where he'd been before, a long time ago, and he saw his spiritual master was there, but he was unconscious, he was in trance.
他便在温达文的森林到处的漫游，他回到了以前他曾经去过的地方，他在那里发现了自己的灵性导师，但他已经失去了知觉，他处在神定当中。
So Gop Kumar sprinkled some water on him, and he brought him back to external consciousness.
Gop Kumar 就向灵性导师，喷了一些水，洒了一些水，他灵性导师就恢复了外在知觉。
And he bowed down before his spiritual master, and spiritual master could understand what Gop Kumar was thinking.
他向自己的领导师顶盖，他的领导师知道他在想什么。
So spiritual master took his bath, and then he taught him about the different rules, how to use the mantra and how to meditate on the mantra he had given him.
他的领导师沐浴之后，就教导戈巴库马尔。 一些念诵 mantra 的规则，以及该怎样去冥想，怎样念诵 mantra.
Yeah, some of the instructions he was able to tell him by speaking, and other things he would show him how to do it.
有一些训示是他的领导师就亲口告诉他，还有一些是他亲身的做示范。
Just like when you chant mantras, some mantras, you put mantras on different parts of your body.
比如说，我们念诵，有的时候呢，在身体的各个部位的图提拉克的时候，我们在会一边念诵的mantra，一边在做这些事情。You
touch the different parts of the body, you chant different mantras.
有的时候呢，我们会触碰身体的各个部分，同时呢念诵mantra.
And different ways of you put your hands in different positions, make different gestures with your hands.
我们还会用手，就做各种各样的姿势。
And he taught him also how to meditate on the Lord's form. He taught him by pointing and showing, giving different signs to him, showed him how he could meditate on the Lord's form. Sometimes he would just show him how to do it, he wouldn't tell him, because if he would tell him, it would awaken the love, the ecstasy in his heart. So his guru told him, "You are very dear to me, so I have given you everything that I have to give you." You just, the power of this mantra, with the power of this mantra, you will understand everything. And you can get everything you want.
其实这首mantra的力量，你就能明白一切，也能得到你想要的一切。
So, by the mercy of the Guru, you can actually get transcendental knowledge, or can awaken in the heart.
其实Guru的仁慈就可以得到超人的知识，可以在内心获得这份知识。
We have to have faith. We have to have faith in the spiritual teacher and in Krishna. Then everything is given.
我们必须对灵性导师以及Krishna满怀信心，之后一切就得以揭示。
Some things we know now, and there are more things to be learned. If we keep following the process, then we will learn everything.
我们现在有一些知识，但是还有更多需要学习的。如果我们一直坚守这个程序，就能了解一切。So
Gop Kumar was very joyful, and he fell at his feet to offer obeisances. But then when he looked up, he saw that his guru had gone. So Gop Kumar was sorry that his guru had left. But he began to chant his mantra, like the guru had instructed him. So, chanting of the mantra will help. Because the mantra worships the Supreme Lord, so the chanting of the mantra helps one to get liberation.
Mantra 因此便能帮助人获得解脱。
But we have to follow the rules and regulations given by the spiritual master.
但是我们还得遵守灵性导师给予的规范原则。
So Gop Kumar was he chanted the mantra as his guru had instructed him, and he saw his body change into a form transcendental to the five material elements: earth, water, fire, air, ether.
Gop Kumar 念了诵 mantra 之后，发现他自己的躯体已经改变了，他有了一个超然于五大元素的个躯体，超越于土、水、火、空气、以太这种的五大元素。
So his body changed into some transcendental form, and it traveled up the universe, and he saw all the different planetary systems.
超然的躯体了，他的躯体现在就他的形象现在就往上旅行，超越了宇宙间的所有的星系。
So he didn't have to die. He gave up one body, got another body, but it wasn't like death in the material world.
不用死亡，他不需要放弃一个躯体，获得另外一个躯体，他不需要经历这个物质世界这种死亡。
So we're going to hear how he traveled through the coverings of the universe, and he enters into the abode of liberation.
我们接下来将听到他是怎样穿破了宇宙的外壳。进入了解脱的境地。
And he said that the doorway to liberation is the sun.
据说解脱的大门是太阳。
So when the devotees and when great brahmacharis, when they're going through the material world, out of the material world,They have to go this way. They go through the sun.
当奉献者，那些伟大的真守生，他们往上旅行的时候，他们就会经历这样的过程。他们必须要经过穿越太阳。
So Gop Kumar went through the sun and traveled upwards. He saw all the 14.Planetary, all the 14 levels of different planets in the universe.
Gopal Kumar 接着又往上晋升，他看到了宇宙间的14个星系。
Right, the Earth planet, we're like the seventh, or we're the seventh level, or the eighth level in the universe.
我们这个地球呢？就是这个第七层，也是宇宙间的第八层次的这个星球。
So we're in the middle. We can experience some heaven and some hell.
因为我们这个地球啊，处在中间。所以能够体验到天堂，也能够体验到地狱的，有这种双重体验。
So while he was going through the universe, he could see all the different planets in the material world, that they were all just like some kind of illusion. They were like some dream.
他就这样呢，就穿越了这整个的宇宙。物质世界的所有的星系，他看到一切都好像梦幻一般。
So material world is like that. It's very temporary. It's not eternal.
这样的，它短暂不恒。
And the happiness of the material world is also like that. It's like an illusion, like a dream.
物质世界的快乐也是像这些梦幻一般，它并不是真实的。
So previously, Gob Kumar had traveled to the different planets. He'd gone from the earth planet, he'd gone to heaven, and from heaven he'd gone up to Mahaloka and Tapaloka, and then Brahmaloka.
在此之前 Gob Kumar 呢曾经从地球旅行到了天堂，又从天堂去了 Mahaloka, 接着又去了 Tapaloka.
So previously, when he'd gone there, it'd taken a long time to go to each of these places.
上一次呢，他是用了很长的时间，就在每一个就上述的星系就待了很久。
But now he's traveling, and he sees all these different places, and it's all gone, and just like a blink of the eye, very quickly.Very quickly passed through all the places, just like you travel by the power of the mind.
而这一次的旅途呢，他看到了所有这上述的这些景象，就像眨眼一样，他经过了所有这些星系，他是就以心意的速度，以心意的力量来旅行。
So.Gob Kumar, he was able to get through from this through the material world and go beyond that, these different planet systems.
Gob Kumar 就这样，他就是穿越了所有这些物质世界的各个星系，并且超越了所有这些星系。
And then he reaches the coverings, the different layers which are covering the universe.
他穿越了宇宙的种种的覆盖，最后到达了宇宙的外壳。
And the first one he reaches was the earth covering.
首先呢，他到达了土这一层覆盖层。
Right. After the earth, then there's water, and then there's fire, and each layer is 10 times the earth one is the finest, and then the water is 10 times the earth one, and then the fire is 10 times the fire. So each layer increases as we go out of the universe.
这个宇宙的时候呢，就每一个覆盖层，比如说水这个覆盖层就是土这一层覆盖层的十倍，土火的覆盖层呢又是水的覆盖层的十倍。
And each of these elements, there's a lot of enjoyment. They offer so much opulence and enjoyment, the feeling of pleasure within each of the layers.So when Gob Kumar entered into the earth element, then he has to take also a body like that. His body has to become made up of the same element in order to enter into that element.
当哥巴库马尔他进入这个土元素所组成的覆盖层的时候呢，他的躯体已经变了，改变成用土元素组成的这样的躯壳。同样的呢，他经历别的覆盖层的时候，他的躯体的元素也都是由那种元素组成。
Right, so if we want to get out of the material universe, we have to go through these coverings.
我们要离开这个物质宇宙的时候呢，就要穿越所有这些物质宇宙这各个元素组成的外壳。
So what happens? You get, they give you, as you, when you come to the earth layer first, we get a subtle body made of the earth element.
就当我们穿越这个土元素这层外壳的时候呢，这层覆盖的时候，我们就得到了一个由土元素的这个精组成的精微躯体。
And in each of the layers, there's so much opportunity for material enjoyment, material pleasures.
在每一个覆盖的外壳这个元素当中呢，都有很多的物质享乐的机会。
Because material creation is made in such a way that you can find some kind of pleasure there.
因为物质创造的这样的物质的创造就是让人能在这个物质创造当中能找到一些快乐。
Conditioned souls get a lot of pleasure from the different elements, from these different elements, earth, water, fire, air.They are all made to give pleasure for the different people, for all the living entities.
贫困的灵魂，它在所有这些这个物质元素的当中呢，都能找到一些快乐。
So, each of the coverings is, you find more happiness.Much even more than you could find on Brahmaloka. And Brahmaloka was the highest planet in the universe. But in the covering of the universe, you find even more happiness.
Brahmaloka 上已经有很多很多的快乐了，但是这个物质宇宙的外壳能给生活条件限制的生物提供更多的快�e。
So Gop Kumar describes when he was traveling, he came first to the earth covering, and when he entered into that earth covering, he saw the Supreme Lord in the form of a great boar.
Gop Kumar, 他首先就进入这个土元素组成的外壳，在那里，他看见了至尊主的雄猪化身的形象。
And he saw also the goddess of the earth planet, and she was worshipping the Lord of, in the form of the boar.
他看到一个地球的女神，就在崇拜主的这雄猪的形象的化身。
She was worshipped him with great opulence, riches that we could never imagine in this planet.
他以就这个星球上无法想象的富裕在崇拜。
So when Gop Kumar had gone to Brahmaloka before, he had seen the Lord in the form of the Mahapurush.
Brahmaloka 的时候，看见至尊主的 Mahapurush 形象。
But he did not see all the opulence of the 14 worlds in the Lord's body.
但他没有在主的身体当中看到所有的这个富裕。
But now he's seeing the Lord in the form of Varaha, the Lord in the form of the boar, and he sees all the opulence.Is within the body of Lord Varaha.
但是他现在亲眼见到了主 Varaha， 就在主 Varaha 的身体当中看见所有的富裕。
So the point is, as we get closer and closer to get out of the material world, we see more and more the opulence of the Supreme Lord.
重点就是当我们。越来越离开这个物质世界的时候，我们就能见到主越来越多的富裕。
the higher planets are more opulent than the lower planets.
高等星系比低等星系更加富裕。
And so the deities of the different coverings of the universe are more opulent than the other gods or devas.
因此，一个宇宙的不同外壳的神像，就比其他的 deva 其他的神祇就更加富裕。
So the goddess of the earth planet.Who is there in the subtle covering of the earth? She's above Brahma.
地球女她在这个土元素的这个外壳，处在这个外壳当中的地球女神，她就比 she's more opulent than Brahma. 她比 Brahma 更富裕。
Yeah.So within the goddess Earth, this Earth which is covering the universe, this is a subtle form of creation, subtle cause of creation. Within the goddess Earth, this is a subtle form of creation. So Gop Kumar could see all the elements of the creation within the body of the goddess.
Gop Kumar 就能在这个女神身上看见所有的这个精微元素。
So, just like in the material world,Earth is the most prominent ingredient. There's a lot of earth here on this material planet.
在这物质的星球，这个物质世界的这个地球这个星球呢，可以看到很多的土元素。
So the goddess Earth, who is actually Bhumi, of course, she is like the source of all creation.So she was worshipping the Lord, Bhumi was worshipping Lord Varaha, and after she finished worshipping him, then she saw Gop Kumar.
地球女神呢，正在崇拜主瓦拉哈，崇拜完之后，她就看见 Gop Kumar.
And when she saw Gop Kumar, she honored him because she thought, oh, a guest has come. She treated him very nicely. And she begged him, please stay with us for a few days. But she told him,Come and stay here with us for some time. Don't go.
他告诉他，快进来，跟我们待一段时间，不要离开。
But Gop Kumar said that he felt some kind of force was pulling him, and he couldn't stay. He was pulled out. He was pulled through there. He said he had to leave quickly. He wanted to get through the covering, and he reached the next covering.
但是 Gopa Kumar 说，他感觉到有一种力量在拉他，他停不下来，他要尽快离开这一个覆盖层，进入下一个覆盖层。
Because there's seven coverings, so he'd only gone through one. He has still has six more coverings to go through.
因为一共有七层，七个外壳，所以他现在只是进入了一个外壳，还剩下有六个外壳。
So, you know, Mother Bhumi, she's a Vaishnava, she's a very, very good devotee, and she wanted Gop Kumar to stay, but he couldn't.
地球女神她是个 Vaishnava, 他希望 Gopal Kumar 留下来，但是 Gopal Kumar 他无法停下脚步。
Because Gopkumar has very strong sadhana, he does a good sadhana, so he couldn't get attached to just stay there and enjoy. He had to go, he had to pass through because he wants to go to the abode of liberation. So it came to each of the elements, and each of the elements there were deities of each of the coverings, and they were all worshipping the Lord in each of the places.
每一个元素的神像都在崇拜着主。So
when he went after the earth covering, he came to the water covering, and in the water covering, he saw the Lord there as Matsya.
在土的这个外壳之后呢，下个外壳是水，是元素组成的外壳。这个在这个外壳当中。
And after the water, the next element was fire. And in fire, the Lord was there as Surya Bhagavan.
在水的这个外壳，下一个外壳呢，是火元素的外壳。
And after fire, next covering is air, and in air, the deity there is Pradyumna.
在火元素的外壳，下个外壳包裹着火元素的外壳是空气的外壳，他崇拜的是 Pradyumna 神像。
And then after air, then comes the ether. And in ether, the Lord is there as Anirudh.
空气外壳，包裹着空气外壳，下面的是以太的外壳。以太外壳的神像在崇拜的是Anirudh。
And then the next one was ego. And ego, the deity, is Sankarshan.
下一个外壳是假物，自我组成的外壳。他在崇拜是Sankarshana。And the last
element is called the Mahat. The Mahat means the Mahat, it's a combination of all the elements. And there the Lord is Vasudev.
下一个外壳叫 Mahat， 这是所有元素的合并体。在那里呢，崇拜的神像是 Vasudev。
So each of the coverings is the cause of the next covering. Each of the covering was the cause of the one before it. Each of the covering was the cause of the one which was before it. Just like fire was the cause of the earth. Fire was the cause of water. Water was the cause of earth. Like that.
前一个外壳的构成的原因，比如说火外壳是水这层覆盖的原因，而水这层覆盖呢又是土这层覆盖的原因。
So The watery covering is closer to the spiritual world than the earth covering.
因此，水这个覆盖层离灵性世界的距离就比土这个覆盖层离灵性世界的距离要近。
So in the watery covering, we can see more. The Lord reveals Himself more in the watery covering than in the earth covering.
在水这个覆盖层，我们可以看到更多。在这个覆盖层当中，主展示的富裕要超越了土的覆盖层。
So the God of the water is greater than the God of earth.
水神的富裕要超越土神的富裕。
And the watery region is more opulent than the earth region. The watery covering is more opulent than the earth covering.
水的外覆盖层的外壳要比土的这个覆盖层的外壳更富裕。
And as you go through the different coverings, it becomes more and more opulent.
随着就穿越每一个覆盖层，这个就变得越来越富裕了。
So finally, he came to the last covering, and when he came to the last covering, then he saw that there was a subtle form of ignorance, which was a beautiful, very beautiful dark blue color.
他穿越了每一个覆盖层之后呢，最后他看见了愚昧的精微形象，他有深蓝色的美丽的形象，美丽的肤色。
So when he came through each of the layers, each of the covering, each place there was a, he was invited to stay there, and they welcomed him. They told him, "Don't leave, please stay with us."
他穿越每一个覆盖都受到了这个覆盖层的神像的邀请，他们就邀请他，你不要走，你留在这儿。
But Gop Kumar was he was being pulled through by the grace of the Lord. He was being pulled through to get through these layers to come to liberation.
Gop Kumar, 他就感觉到主的力量在拉动着他，让他进入了解脱的境地。
And so then he came to the last covering of, which is covering of Prakriti. And all the other coverings, they come from that.
最后他就到了最后一个外壳是 Prakriti， 所有其他的外壳呢都是从这 Prakriti 而来的。
So that dark blue color is associated with ignorance, you see, the ignorance of the material world. It's described in the 10th canto when Krishna took Arjuna. They went to get back the Brahmana's children because the Brahmana, his wife, had had a miscarriage. So Krishna and Arjuna went to bring back the children of the Brahmana.
圣经《博伽瓦坛》第十篇当中描述的，当 Krishna 和 Arjuna 他们去把婆罗门的孩子们带回来的时候的故事。这个婆罗门的妻子呢，她怀孕了，然后就流产了。Krishna 和 Arjuna 去给他们带回他们孩子。
So Krishna had to take Arjuna on his chariot. They had to go through the covering of the universe.
Krishna 就把尔朱娜放在战车上，他们就穿越了所有宇宙的覆盖。
And when they came through the coverings, it was very dark. So Krishna had to release the Sudarshan Chakra to light up the whole place. Okay, so Gop Kumar, when he saw this dark blue color everywhere, he was thinking, oh, this is the same color as Madan Gopal, my deity. So he was very happy. He thought, oh, this is very nice. I should stay here. Because he thought this color, this is the same color as my Lord. He has this blue color, so he thought, this must be the place, I should stay here. So the goddess Prakriti was there. You know, she's the deity of that covering, the last covering. And she was there and she had just been worshipping the Lord. And she had just finished the worship. And so she saw Gop Kumar and she came to see him, to speak to him. She was actually, Prakriti was worshipping the Lord. The Lord was in the form of Mohini Murti, which is, you know, his female form. And Prakriti was worshipping him.
Prakriti, 女神崇拜的是 Mohini Murti 神像。
So we're attracted by Maya, but Maya is attracted by Mohini Murti. She was worshipping the Lord in the form of Mohini Murti. We worship Maya, but Maya worships the Lord.
崇拜着玛雅，受到深受玛雅的吸引。可是呢，玛雅却在崇拜的，她崇拜的对象是摩诃尼穆提，是主的女性的这种形象。So
when she saw Gop Kumar, she blessed Gop Kumar with a yoga siddhi. She gave him anima siddhi, which is a great yoga power. And she also asked him, please stay here, come and stay with us for some time. And she told him, I know your goal is to get liberation. But if you're kind to me, then I can give you liberation. I'm the one who gives liberation. So you should be kind to me. You should stay with me for some time.
女神对Gopakumar说,
so sometimes we think liberation means to give up the material nature. But actually what happens is the material nature has to release us, let us go, then we can get liberation. It's not that we give up material nature. Material nature has to give us up.
But 放弃物质自然，而是物质自然要放手我们，我们才可以离开。
So, Prakriti tells Gop Kumar, if you want devotion to Lord Vishnu, you should be kind and worship me, because I also give devotion.
Prakriti 告诉 Gop Kumar, 你想获得对 Vishnu 的奉爱，那你就应该好好的对待我，崇拜我，我能赐予对 Vishnu 的奉爱。
Yeah, I am the sister of Vishnu, and I am also his servant.
我是 Vishnu 的妹妹，我也是 Vishnu 的仆人。
And I'm the form of his energy.
我是他的能量的形象。
So one who is a devotee, we don't worry, we don't care for liberation, but we have to respect Prakriti.
Right.
She is the sister of Krishna. She was born as Subhadra from the womb of Yashoda. Right. When Vasudev came there after birth, he brought Krishna to the home of Nanda Maharaj, and he took away the girl from Mother Yashoda. So that girl was Subhadra. And Kamsa tried to kill her, but she rose up in the air. So this is the Subhadra. This is none different from Prakriti.
Nanda Maharaj 的家的时候呢，他就拿走了抱走了亚修的新诞生的女儿，这个女儿就是 Subhadra。 后来康瑟想要杀死女神，这个女婴呢就升到半空当中，所以 Subhadra 就是 Prakriti。
And she can help a devotee to progress in devotional service.
他可以帮助奉献者在奉爱服务当中进步。
Okay, so Gop Kumar, however, he didn't want to accept any of these things.
Gop Kumar 可不想接受所有这些。
He knew them. He knew all this just to be the potency of Lord Vishnu, and he bowed down to the goddess. And he looked around for a while to see the beauty of that region, because it was very beautiful, very colorful. So he wanted to enjoy that for some time, but he didn't want to accept any of the benediction.
知道这些能量都是主威生能量，他顶拜了女神之后呢，他环顾了四周，就看到了这一区域的美丽，这个区域的色彩缤纷，他在那里享受了一会儿，但是他不接受这地方给予的好处。
Yeah, because it was such an amazing place. It was so attractive to the mind and senses. It was shining. It was everything was so pleasing about it. There were many living entities enjoying it, and their bodies were all very beautiful.
This place is a very amazing place. It is very attractive to the mind, attractive to the heart, and everything is shining and glowing. It makes one feel happy.
So this is actually the form of pradan. Pradan is the unmanifest stage of the material nature. Pradan. It's the most subtle form of the material energy.
So, 叫做 pradam， 它是物质自然不展示的，物质自然不展示的形象，它有着最为精微的形体，是物质的能量。
So Gop Kumar saw how some living entities had bodies made of this pradam, transcendental to the material world.
Gopal Kumar 看到有一些生物的躯体是由 pradam 所构成的，超越了物质的世界。
So, everything in that region was inconceivable, and it was so opulent. All the forms were the present. Many different forms were there all at one time.
那个区域，一切都是那么不可思议。那么富裕，那里的形，那里有很多的形象，就是同时存在着很多的形象。
All the elements of the creation, subtle and gross, was all there.
创造的一切元素，无论精微还是粗糙，全都在那里。
So this is the nature of pradan.That it's the source of everything in the material creation.
This is pradam 的本质，它是所有的创造的源泉。
It cannot be understood by the material mind.
物质的心意是无法理解的。
It cannot be described in words.
言语无法形容。
It's the most subtle of all things in the material creation.
它是物质创造当中最为精微的存在。
So Gop Kumar is traveling through these different regions, and he passes through each region.Different senses are there. He could have enjoyed them, but he wants to go further. He wants to get liberation.
Gopakumar 就穿越了所有这些的区域，在那里有不同的感官。他本来是可以享受所有这些感官的。但他没有停下来享受，因为他想要得到解脱。
And if you want to get liberation, you have to give up all material desires.
倘若想要得到解脱，就必须放弃所有的物质欲望。
So Gop Kumar came through that region of ignorance, and he came to a place which was.Very light and brilliant, unbearably bright light, and forced him to close his eyes. The light was so bright, he closed his eyes.
Gopal Kumar, 他就超越了这个所有这些愚昧的这些形象。接下来呢，他就进入一片光芒。璀璨的一个区域，这光芒是如此的强烈，他忍不住就闭上了双眼。
So, Gop Kumar was struggling to look, and then when he opened his eyes, he could see the Supreme Lord, effulgent like many millions of suns, in front of him.
Gopal Kumar 努力的就想。睁开眼睛看一看，当他最终睁开眼睛的时候，看见至尊主在他面前，就像上百万个太阳一样，光芒四射。
So Gop Kumar could see the Lord in his wonderful form. He saw him it was brought ecstasy to his mind. He could see the Lord, how powerful he was, and he was decorated with many ornaments and beautiful features.
Gopakumar 看见主的这个奇妙的形象，他的心里感到狂喜。主充满了力量，他佩戴着各种装饰品，他的容貌是非常有魅力的。
So, Gopakumar seeing the Lord like this, and he felt great happiness, great bliss.
Gopakumar 看到主的这个形象，感觉到非常的快乐，感到极乐。
The body of the most exalted person should have special features in their body, things like.The palm of their hand should be red, and the sole of their feet should be red.
受到崇拜的人物，他一定是有着非常独特的容貌的。比如说，他的手掌是红色的，他的足后跟也是红色的。
And there should be 32 special marks in the body, indicating perfection.And Gopakumar could see all of these in the body of the Lord.
在这样的人的身上呢，有32个特征标志，它是完美的标志。Gopakumar 在主的身上看到所有这些完美的特征。
So Gopakumar had left behind the darkness, all the darkness of the material nature.Now he is seeing the Lord better than he had ever seen before.
Gopakumar 离开了黑暗的物质自然，他现在亲眼看到的主是他从未见过的。
Okay, so we will stop there today. We'll hear more what happens in the abode of liberation. We're going to hear.About pure devotional service in the region of liberation.
我们就讲到这里，以后我们将讲到解脱以及纯粹的奉爱。
Sanatan Goswami wrote this book to describe to us about the different levels which we have to go through to go back to Godhead.
Swami 撰写了这部书籍，他描述了当我们回归神手的时候，必须要经历的不同的层面。
And he's going to describe to us the highest of all relationships which we can have with the Lord.
他描述我们可以跟主建立的最高的关系。
And we'll hear about the highest place that we can associate with the Lord. Okay, are there any questions?
The first question is from Zhimin, obeisance Guru Maharaj, obeisance to all the devotees present. The first question is that, is every incarnation of the Lord reside in an independent planet, or after the mission is finished, this incarnation will go back to the body of the Lord.
Oh. Well, we said, see, these are like demigods, these different incarnations who are in each of the different elements of the coverings of the universe. They're not the Supreme Lord. Right, they're so the Lord has his own place in each, just like these different forms of the Lord, Varaha, Matsya, and so on, they have their own planet in the spiritual world, in Vaikuntha Loka.
瓦拉哈、玛西亚这些形象呢，他们在百昆塔有自己的星球。
But these deities in each of the coverings, they're like demigods who have coming there, who are representing the Lord, and they're there in these coverings are there in each universe.
这每个宇宙呢都有这些覆盖层，而这些覆盖的外壳的这个神像呢，是半神人们，他们代表着至尊主去那里。So
at the end of Brahma's life, everything will be taken back into the body of Mahavishnu.
在 Brahma 的寿命结束的时候。
And then these different deities, they'll enter back into the bodies of the original deity in the spiritual world.
这些不同的神像，他们就回到了。 灵性原本的这个神像那里。Or
they will enter into the body of Mahavishnu, and they will stay there in the body of Mahavishnu, and they will wait until the creation, and then they will take birth again when the Lord creates again.
嗯，you mean the deity of the covering?
Yeah.
然后。 在这个宇宙结束的时候呢，这个每个覆盖层的这些半神人们、这些神像嘛，他们被吸收到马阿维什努身体里，等到下一次创造之后，就再次又出来。Because
with the creation, again, they have to have the deity in each of the coverings.
因为每一个创造。 开始的时候呢，在每一个覆盖的外壳里面，都必须有各自的神像，各自的伴，就是主宰神。The next question, 那，所方知名，我们躯体的组成五大元素和精微躯体，和刚刚讲的每一层的外壳覆盖的元素是一样的吗？ The five elements and the subtle body that made up of our body, is it the same as just now you mentioned in the each layer of the universe?
Is what the same as each layer of the universe?
The elements, the five elements
of the body.
Yes, and also the subtle body, she asked, that made up of our body, is it the same as you mentioned in the lecture?
Yeah, it's the same.
是一样的。
But when Gop Kumar entered into that element, into that covering, he had to take on a special body. He had to give up that body which he had. His body became a transcendental body, and he entered into the covering. So without having that transcendental body, he couldn't enter into that element, into that covering.
没有个超然躯体是无法进入这个外壳的，无法进入各个元素的这个外壳。
So you go into the covering of water, you have to have a watery body. You go into covering of fire, you have to have a fiery body.
当进入水的这个外壳的时候，你得有一个水元素的外壳躯体；当进入火元素的外壳的时候，得有一个火元素的躯体。
Okay, 下一个问题。
下一个，顶拜 Maharaj， Subhadra 是 Prakriti 女神，是高等 Prakriti 还是低等 Prakriti？ Subhadra 与 Durga 女神有什么关系？
Gaudang Prakriti is a Didang Prakriti. Subhadra, let me check what did they say. What did they say here about that? Yeah, just a minute. Yeah, I'll have to look into that and see. Oh wait, here. Yeah, it's here. Subhadra. Yeah, here. Subhadra born from the womb of Yashoda, he has a. Although Vishnu is not identical with Lord Vishnu's internal, Maya is not identical with Lord Vishnu's internal energy. She is the expansion of that energy. So, she's not identical with the Antaranga Shakti, but she's the expansion of the Antaranga. She's like the shadow, just like the shadow is not different from the person. So she's like the shadow of the original energy. She's the expansion of the Antaranga Shakti. And she appears in the external elements. She makes her appearance, she appears to be in the external elements. The external elements means the material elements, elements of the material world. She appears. Right, when Kamsa came to kill her, she rose up in the air, right? Kamsa couldn't harm her. So she has a divine body.
Kamsa came to kill her, 他就一下飞到了半空当中。
So it says here, she's not identical with the Antaranga Shakti, but she's the expansion. Okay.
下一个问题, Jogadi Devadasi, Hare Krishna, 感恩布鲁讲课。 我们念诵 Hare Krishna Mantra， 如果终于有一天我们要回归灵神手，灵世界的飞机载着我们，我们也会经过层层覆盖吗？ Hare Krishna， thank you for Guru's lecture. When we chant Hare Krishna Mantra， ultimately at last， one day we will go back to Godhead。 The airplane from spiritual world carried us. Should we also travel through these different layers?
Yes. Yes.
是的.
And we will be tested. If you have any attraction to enjoy, then you won't go. Just like Gop Kumari, they're telling him, don't go, come and stay here, come and enjoy here. So much happiness, so much enjoyment. But Gop Kumar said, no, no, I have to go, sorry. So we have to really want to get out from the material world. If we still have some desire to enjoy, we will be trapped, we will stay.
如果我们还有享乐的欲望的话，就会被抓住、被缠绕、束缚住，就走不开了。嗯哼。下一个问题。 There's no more questions.
Oh, okay. So we finish there.
那我们讲到这儿。 More questions coming. Chen Guanjiang, Chaitanya Charandas, Krishna, 明白不对？ 宇宙覆盖层也有生物在活动吗？ 刚才听讲课覆盖层的感官享乐比宇宙各星球还高，当我们回灵世界时，会不会被宇宙中的绚丽吸引？ 回不去呢? Hare Krishna, this is Gurudev. In this different layer of the universe, are there any living entities have their own activity there?
Yes.
Just now, 有。You mentioned in your lecture the sense gratification. Sense enjoyment in these different layers is higher than various planets in the universe. So when we go back to the spiritual world, is there any possibility we are attracted by the colorfulness of the universe and cannot go back?
Yes, very possible.
是的。 很有可能我们被吸引,
these tests are given to all the living entities before you can go back to Godhead.
在回归神手之前，就是考验是给每一个生物体的。
We have to just simply want to get to be with Krishna. If we're still attracted to enjoying the material world, then we will stay here in the material world. So we have to take full shelter of Krishna.
Next question is from Radha Priya Devadasi, 顶拜姑的莲花族，感恩翻译主持人的服务。今天课程里，Gopal Kumar 的躯体发生变化，我们通过念诵圣名，躯体会发生变化吗？如果有变化，是被回灵性世界的躯体变化吗？ Obeisance Guru Maharaj, you mentioned that the Gopal Kumar's body has changed. By chanting the holy name, will our body also change? If there are indeed any change, if this change for the body that's prepared to go back to the spiritual world?
Yes, right. Right. The body does change, yeah. Chanting Hare Krishna, definitely. We change the body, we become different. Prabhupada saw before the devotee, when people first come to Krishna consciousness, they're dirty and their faces are not happy and they're just coming out of the material world and they look very different. But once they become devotees, they become very bright faced and happy and healthy, living in Krishna consciousness. They look like they came from Vaikuntha with neck beads and tilak and shaved heads.
就是当人们来到 Krishna 知觉之前呢，他们是脏兮兮的，有一点都不开心，因为他们刚是从物质世界来的，而之后呢，他们就有了变化了，就不一样了。那奉献者他们都是容光焕发的，他们既高兴又健康，他们在 Krishna 知觉当中很开心，他们就像从 Vaikuntha 那里来的，他们涂着提拉克，带着净珠。
So yes, the body does change. The mind changes completely. The body also changes. With the mind changing, the body changes. We become happy, we become joyful soul. We're developing our spiritual body so that we can go back to Krishna. How you want to, ma?
还有一个，是不是 Hari Vamsa Das 是不是意味着现在 ISKCON 的圣帕帕德的门徒已经帮帕帕德创立了 Varnashram Dharma 这制度，我们中奉献者怎么应用这一系统呢？ That mean that in ISKCON the disciples of Srila Prabhupada have helped Srila Prabhupada establish Varnashram Dharma system. How can our Chinese devotees apply this Varnashram Dharma system?
How can Chinese devotees apply Varnashram Dharma system? Well, by working for Krishna. Whatever you do it for Krishna. You'd be an ideal householder. Take care of your wife and family for Krishna. Keep the house Krishna conscious and clean and be, regulated and worship Krishna.
Krishna，而工作，无论不管做什么事情，都是为了Krishna而去做的，成为理想的居士，为Krishna来管打理自己的家庭，把自己的家变成跟Krishna有关系的，为Krishna的家庭，家里非常的清洁，生活呢起居非常有规律，崇拜Krishna。
If you have the job, if you're working in the job, then you have to be a good, you should be ideal worker, so be regular, be punctual, work nicely, be pleasing to people, keep good relationships, friendly relationships with people, be happy in your work.
就应该成为一个理想的典范的工人，好好的员工，清洁准时，就很好的履行你的工作，并且呢，你也能够取悦，非常令他人感到愉悦，也建立很友善的关系，你自己呢非常的快乐。
And somebody else may be doing business, you have a business, okay, then you work. You do it also, you think Krishna's business, and you work, make some money for Krishna, to use in Krishna's service.
如果你有自己的生意的话，就把它变成Krishna的生意，你赚钱，然后用来做服务。
Of course, it's also nice if you can get some land, you can grow your own vegetables. Get some land, you cultivate the land, grow some vegetables, you can maintain yourself. You don't have to purchase from the market. That's very nice.
如果你有土地的话，就在土地上种植蔬菜，可以维持你的生活，不需要从市场上购买。
Try to be more self-sufficient. Don't depend on the material world.
努力变得自足自立，不依赖物质世界。
And for the women have their duties as a wife, and the Sri Dharma, their duty is to serve the husband, to keep the house clean, and to please the husband by cooking for him and taking care of the family.
女性来说，她们有自己的职责，Sri Dharma，她们要服务丈夫，让房间保持清洁，取悦丈夫，为丈夫做饭，照顾家庭。If
the wife does the puja, then the husband also gets the benefit. They share the benefit. They share each other's pious and sinful reactions.
如果妻子在家中做崇拜铺着的话，丈夫也能分享这份铺着崇拜的结果，就是无论前程的活动也好，最后的活动也罢，这个夫妻双方都要共享这个活动的反应。
So Varnashram is the system to organize society. So that everybody should have some work, they should be properly engaged, working in the service of Krishna.
Varnashram制度是对社会的一个组织，每一个人都要从事工作，他们都应该恰当的履行各自的工作。
Okay, any more? How you want, Tima?
还有最后一个 Paramahamsa Das， 听说人离开躯体，大部分人大脑没有知觉，处在潜意识状态，很难记住Krishna。 让 Krishna 记得我们做的服务。主具体怎么帮忙让我们记起主呢？ I heard that when most people leave their body, the brain is unconscious, is in subconsciousness, very hard to remember Krishna, but Krishna can remember all our devotional service. Specifically, how can the Lord help us to remember Him?
How can the Lord help us to remember Him? Well, the Lord helps us because He's the super soul in the heart of every living entity. So He helps us to remember Him from the heart.
Because 主是众生心中的超灵，所以主是从内心当中帮助我们来记住他。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says,From Him comes knowledge, remembrance, and forgetfulness. So that's the function of the Super Soul. If we want to remember Him, Krishna can help us to remember Him.
In the 薄伽梵歌当中呢，主说，记忆、知识、遗忘都是从我而来，因为主是超灵，所以他能帮。如果我们想要记住他的话，主就能帮助我们记住他。
And Krishna also is very helpful because he comes and speaks the Bhagavad Gita. And by speaking Bhagavad Gita, so we can read the Bhagavad Gita and we can read Krishna's words, and that helps us to think of Krishna.
Krishna, 他也通过讲薄伽梵歌帮助我们。当我们读薄伽梵歌的当中的字字句句的时候，就是帮助我们能够想着 Krishna.
Then in the form of the holy name, he comes in the form of the holy name, and he also comes in his different incarnations, like Lord Chaitanya, and he came to propagate the chanting of the holy name.
他也以圣名的形式降临，他也以各个也以化身的形式，主 Chaitanya 就是主 Chaitanya 就是 Krishna 降临来传播圣名。
So Krishna is helping us. He's doing all of these things to help us to remember Him.
Krishna 就做了所有这一切，目的是帮助我们能够记住他。
He's trying to help us. He's trying to bring us back home, back to Godhead.
他努力地帮助我们。回归家园，回归神手。
But Lord Chaitanya says, in the Shikshastikam, Lord Chaitanya said, we're very unfortunate that although Krishna comes in the form of His holy name, we're very unfortunate, we have no desire, we have no interest to chant.
主 Chaitanya 在八训规当中说，我们非常不幸，尽管 Krishna 前来给予我们圣名，但是我们是这么不幸，我们既不想念诵圣名，也对念诵圣名没有兴趣。
So we have to try to develop some attraction for Lord Krishna, and we have to understand how kind Krishna is, how merciful He is, how He's trying to help us.To come to Him.
So we have to try to develop for these things, the above these things, the attraction. Lord Krishna, we should think that Lord Krishna is too merciful, too kind, to help us reach to Him. But
we get lost in the material world. We're just thinking about our own little existence.We're thinking about our own family, our own circle.
我们迷失在物质世界，我们只想着自己渺小的存在，只顾着自己的小家，顾着自己的小圈子。
Okay.
问题。
Yeah.
PTLU， 顶拜敬爱的古圣Guru Dev， 请问有时候身体不好就会烦躁不安，心意不稳，有时候生气愤怒，人们就会得病。那么是不是躯体和心意相互影响呢？念诵圣名使我们提高灵性，提高也会改善身体健康吧。我们给他人传教时，可以告诉他人念诵 Hare Krishna 能使人健康吗？
Yes, you can tell people if you chant Hare Krishna you'll be healthy.
可以，可以告诉人们你念诵 Hare Krishna 就能变得健康。
But we have to be regulated. We have to chant regularly. Have to make it a habit every day.
但是我们必须养成习惯、规范，就每天都要念。
Material body is there. Material body has problems. Sometimes we get sick, and so on. And so that is inevitable with the material body.
物质的躯体会有问题的，有的时候会有疾病，这些是不可避免的。
But if we're chanting Hare Krishna, it will be our situation will improve. We will certainly improve. We will change a lot of our karma, and we will not have to suffer so much.
但是。当我们念诵 Hare Krishna 的时候呢，我们的境况就会得到改善，我们的 karma 也会变化，我们就无需我们受的苦就不会那么多了。
And the anger and the moods, these things should be stopped because this is due to the uncontrolled mind.
愤怒啊，还有这些情绪啊，必须停止，因为这都是。
So when we chant Hare Krishna, then we'll learn to control the mind, and we'll help to stop all of these irritations of the mind, the anger, and the bad mood and the nastiness which comes out. This is all due to the uncontrolled mind.
当我念诵 Hare Krishna 的时候呢，这些失控的这些情绪啊，这些心理的这些刺激都必须得停止，这些都是这些内心的这些不洁都是由于心意的失控导致的。
So chanting Hare Krishna will help us to awaken our spiritual consciousness.
唱诵 Hare Krishna 帮助我们唤醒灵性的知觉，
which is full of bliss and knowledge eternally.
充满着极乐知识永恒。
But when we think of the body, we'll be depressed.
可是如果我们一味想着躯体的话，就会抑郁。
Because the body is only temporary, cannot maintain for long.So we get depressed, we get anxiety. So chant Hare Krishna and be happy. And be healthy also. Okay. How you went, Emma?
Hare Vamsadas， 刚才姑姑说夫妻共享彼此的罪恶和前程，是不是甚至奉献服务的益处？怎么理解？难道不是彼此都是独立的灵魂吗？ Chestnut mentioned the couples share their parts and sinful activity, even devotional benefit of devotional service. How to understand it?Isn't that we are all individuals, so?
Yes, we're individuals, but you work together, you live together. So the results of your work you share with each other. You eat together. Often one person cooks and the other. And so you share each many things. You share your money, you share your house. So there's your karma also becomes connected to each other.
是的，我们都是独立的灵魂，但是呢，我们夫妻他们一起工作，一起居住，结果也会共享。夫妻他们一起做，就是做完饭后一起吃饭，他们的钱财共享，那房子共享，所以他们的karma连接在一起。
Husband and wife, we often speak, the man will speak about the wife as his better half, my better half. And the wife is like half the body of the man. Because she's taking care of the home, she's looking after the child, she's doing many things. Company for the husband, keeps the husband happy.
妻子要照顾家庭、孩子，照料许多事情，她陪伴着丈夫，让丈夫快乐。
But that way, if they become like one, the karma is also connected.
他们就变成了像一个人那样子的，所以他们的karma就是互相连在一起。
So a husband, he has to be a staunch devotee. He has to be attached to Krishna, and the wife, her duty is to follow the husband.
丈夫应该成为一个非常坚强的奉献者，他应该依附 Krishna。
Then they can be get they can both get success in life.
他们的生命，他们夫妻两个人的生活就能共同的取得成功了。
Is it clear?
清楚吗？
Husband has to protect the wife. You have to make sure the wife doesn't do any bad things, so she doesn't get any bad karma.
丈夫要保护妻子，确保妻子不干坏事，从而不会得到那个不好的karma的反应。
And the wife has to also protect the husband from going into Maya.
妻子也要保护丈夫，确保丈夫不要陷入到玛雅假象中。So
they help each other.
他们是互帮互助的。Okay,
Hare Krishna.
下一个 Sumukhi Radha Dasi. 顶拜咕噜马哈拉扯和所有奉献者感恩翻译主持，请问夫妻一方休息，另外一方不休息，会不会因为一方不休息，休息的那个也因为共业回不去呢？中国的情况是丈夫大多数不休，马达吉单休。这种情况结果怎么样呢？中国的情况是丈夫大多数不休，马达吉一个人单休，这种情况结果会怎样呢？ Obeisance Guru Maharaj and all devotees, thank you for the host. The question is that only one practice, the other doesn't practice. So will the one who practice cannot go back due to the other who doesn't practice? Because in China, most husband doesn't practice, and only Madhaji alone practice. So what will be the result from this situation?
Well, we have to see what Krishna wants. It's up to Krishna. Krishna knows everyone's heart, and he knows if the marriage is really attached to Krishna, then he will make arrangements. Yeah, when the devotee becomes initiated and takes full shelter of Krishna, he surrenders to Krishna, then they're not under the laws of karma anymore. But they have to follow very strictly. You cannot cheat Krishna. You may say, oh, I took initiation. Yeah, if you take initiation, then you have to follow the vows at the time of initiation. You have to keep these vows strictly. Then you're safe. Then you're protected. Even though your husband may not be devotee, you're protected because you're strictly following. But if we take initiation and sometimes we follow, sometimes we don't, then we're not really we're not very strict. Then you cannot expect to get full protection.
如果虽然启迪了，却有的时候遵守规范，有的时候不遵守规范，不严格的遵守所有这些规范，那就不能得到完全的保护。Yeah,
if we're chanting faithfully every day, doing the chanting, trying to avoid offenses, then that will protect us.
忠诚的念诵，避免每天都要念诵，避免努力避免冒犯，这样才能得到保护。But
if we don't follow very strictly, then your karma is there. Then you're under the material energy. That means karma, and it means you get karma from your husband also.
如果不严格的遵守的话，那就有karma，那就意味着在物质能量的控制之下，这样那就也受到丈夫的karma的影响。So
we have to come to the transcendental platform. Then you're safe. Then you're protected from karma.
我们必须到达超然的层面，这样就是安全的，这样就能免受里面的karma的影响。So
we kind of go up and down, one day transcendental, next day in the modes of nature, and up and down every other day. That's no good.
不能起起落落。
Bhagavad Gita says, Mamcha Yovaya Bicharena Bhakti Yogena Sevate Sagunam Samatichaitam Brahma Bhuyaya Kalpate. That one who engages in my devotional service without falling down, then they come to the level of Brahman.
Bhagavad Gita says, 完全从事奉献服务，从来不堕落，这样就能达到 Brahman 的层面。
So Brahman is above the modes of nature.
Brahman 是超越了物质自然形态的层面。
Okay, Hare Krishna.
This a question from Harini.
Harini, okay.
顶戴 Guru, 分居很多年的夫妻，还要分享彼此的 karma 吗？感恩故人死，感恩分感，顶拜所有听课的奉献者。
分居多长时间？
The couple they separated for many years. Will
Yeah.
they share karma?
No.
不分享。
No, you're separated, so you won't share the karma.
对，分居了，所以不分享。
Okay.
好的，滚蛋，我
Okay.
们的问题就到这里了。
好。Okay. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.
Jai.
Going back to Vrinda Ki Jai.
Jai.
Guru Mani Ki Jai, Sati Mataji Ki Jai, Guru Mani Mataji Ki Jai, Sayada Funkshyanjur Ki Jai,
Jai,
Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.